Hello, my name is Dr. Christina Compton, and I am the founder of Sewelo Health, a virtual healthcare company where we partner with individual clients and businesses around the world to improve their health and their well-being. And it is such an honor to have been invited by Tamara and David to share a simple, very powerful, and very timely meditation. It's a heart meditation. So my hope is that as you listen and as you experience and feel into the space that we create today, that you will find messages which speak to your heart. And then you will take what feels right for you and remember it. And possibly do your own prayer or meditation. So, before we begin the actual prayer, let's set the stage, the heart stage. So, a few interesting facts. Your heart is located in the center of your chest, slightly to the left. Your heart is the hardest working muscle in your body. It beats around 110,000 times each day, and your heart will beat about 3 billion times in your lifetime. The lub dub beating sound that you may have heard, that sound is the opening and closing of the heart valves. And those opening and closing of the valves allows the old blood to be pumped up and out and then captured within the lungs to grab onto some oxygen. And then that nourishment, that oxygen, is being pumped throughout your body by your heart so that your tissues are revigorated and renewed with the fresh oxygen. Your heart pumps about 2,000 gallons of blood a day. And your heart is absolutely essential for your body's overall health and function. So, when was the last time that you reminded your heart to beat? You're amazing. Just think about that. When was the last time you said, "Heart, I need you to be beating now"? Your body is extremely intelligent, and your body wants to help you. In fact, your body automatically and is quickly responding to what you eat, what you smell, what you hear, how you feel, what you say, and yes, what you think. So, this is why prayer and meditation not only help the mind, but it also helps your body in many ways. I am often asked, "How should I meditate?" Or, "I can't sit still long enough to pray." Prayer and meditation is unique to you, and there's no one right way, only your way. So, whether you are sitting in a chair or on the floor or outside or even when walking, the importance is that you do it. Have the intention. Trust in yourself. And always remember, you are amazing. Your body is incredible. And by you focusing on yourself in a kind and loving way, your body will be overjoyed. So just remember, when you are kind and you're loving to yourself, your body is going to be extremely happy. And all your internal systems and the physiology is all going to get into a rhythm. So as we move into the heart meditation, please remember, you do not need to look outside yourself for answers. You do not need to fight a disease. You do not need to achieve another goal. All is already inside of you. You simply need to remember. Remember that you are already whole and complete, just the way you are. And by doing so, you will develop a stronger root system inside yourself. When the external world is unsettled, your strong roots will help you sway, but not falter. The brilliance of your heart is that it's continually bringing oxygen and life to the tissues throughout your body, again, while moving the old blood out. So there is a continuous in with the new, out with the old transformation inside of you. Call on the heart to help you transform what is old and no longer needs or serves you in your life. Ask your heart to bring in the new. Ask your heart to pull in life so that your internal root system can get stronger. Become the gardener or the farmer of your internal soil or your internal ecosystem.